In this video, we're going to start the CUDA Software Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Angles in a Triangle. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now our directions state to find the measure of each angle indicated, and we're looking at angles in a triangle. So let's go over a few definitions and theorems that will help us in this worksheet. So the first theorem we're going to go over is the triangle sum theorem. That basically states that the three interior angles of a triangle sum or add up to equal 180 degrees. So let's look at number one knowing this. In number one, we have our triangle. We have 65 degrees as one angle, 57 degrees as another angle, and we're trying to find this last angle. Let's call this angle X. We know that the sum of the three interior angles will add up to equal 180 degrees. So 65 degrees plus 57 degrees plus X, which is our unknown, is equal to 180 degrees. Now we're going to simplify and solve for X in order to figure out the measure of that indicated angle. Combining like terms, 65 degrees and 57 degrees, 65 degrees plus 57 degrees equals 122 degrees. We're adding that to X, and that equals 180 degrees. Now we'll subtract 122 degrees from both sides in order to isolate that X. So X is equal to 180 minus 122, which equals 58 degrees. So 58 degrees is our solution in number one. And you can see 65 plus 57 plus 58 does indeed equal 180. In number two, again, we're looking for this third angle. This time, let's call this angle A. We have 40 degrees indicated. This is a symbol for 90 degrees. So this angle is 90 degrees, utilizing the triangle sum theorem. 40 degrees plus 90 degrees plus our unknown A equals 180 degrees. 40 degrees plus 90 degrees is going to give us 130 degrees. So we have 130 degrees plus A is equal to 180. Now we'll subtract 130 from both sides. That'll give us that A is equal to 50 degrees. So 50 degrees is the measure of the indicated angle in number two. And number three, again, all the angles are adding up to equal 180. So we have 20 degrees plus 130 degrees plus our unknown, let's call this Y, is equal to 180 degrees. 20 degrees plus 130 degrees will give us 150 degrees. We're adding Y to that, and that is equal to 180 degrees. When we subtract 150 degrees from both sides, we get that Y is equal to 30 degrees. So 30 degrees is our answer in number three. For number four, we're adding 85 to 50 to our unknown. Let's call this B, and that is equal to 180. Adding 85 degrees to 50 degrees, we'll get 135 degrees. And we're still adding B, and that is equal to 180. So now we'll subtract the sum of the two known angles from 180 degrees in order to get B. So B is equal to 45 degrees in number four. Now in number five, in order to solve this, we're looking at an angle that is outside of the triangle. However, if you look, knowing the definition of a linear pair, if we have a straight line where opposite rays form an angle with common side, so here's one angle and here's another angle, then those angles will add up to equal 180 degrees because they're supplementary. So we have two angles that share a common side where the non-common side is the opposite rays. So just remember, whenever you have a straight line, those angles will add up to equal 180 degrees. Now looking back at our problem, we're trying to find this angle, let's call this X. However, for our triangle sum theorem, we know that this angle plus this angle plus this angle equals 180 degrees. So in order to find this angle X, we have to first find the angle that is supplementary with it, which is this angle here. However, we also have another linear pair, 137 degrees, and this angle here. So we know that 137 degrees plus this angle, let's call this angle A, is equal to 180. So 137 degrees plus A equals 180. So when we subtract 137 degrees from both sides, we'll get the measure of angle A. So angle A is equal to 43 degrees. Now we're going to use our triangle sum theorem in order to solve for this angle B, because we have a triangle with only one unknown angle. So 102 degrees plus 43 degrees plus B will equal 180. So we have 43 degrees plus 102 degrees plus B equals 180 degrees. 43 plus 102 degrees equals 145 degrees. Adding that to B will give us 180. Subtracting 145 from both sides will give us 35 degrees. However, we're still not done, because 35 degrees is equal to B, but we need to find X. And we know that B and X form a linear pair, therefore they're supplementary and add up to 180 degrees. So 35 degrees, our B, plus X equals 180 degrees. So when we subtract 35 degrees from both sides, we'll get that X is equal to 145 degrees. So our indicated angle is 145 degrees for number 5. Moving on to number 6, we're going to utilize another theorem. This theorem is the vertical angle theorem, which says that when two lines intersect, the angles that are not adjacent are congruent. So if we have angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4, angle 1 is congruent to angle 3, since they're opposite and not adjacent. And we also have that angle 4 is congruent to angle 2. So knowing that vertical angles are congruent, we will be able to solve for the indicated angle in number 6. Let's call this angle Y. In order to solve for Y, we first have to solve for this angle. Let's call this angle Z. But in order to solve for Z, we have to also know this angle. Let's call this angle X. And X forms a vertical angle with 35 degrees. And since vertical angles are congruent, we know that X is equal to 35 degrees. So knowing that X is 35 degrees, we can solve for Z and then in turn solve for Y. So in order to solve for Z, we'll have 35 degrees, which is our X, plus 100 degrees plus Z is equal to 180, according to the triangle sum theorem. 35 plus 100 degrees is 135 degrees. We're adding that to Z, and that is equal to 180. When I subtract 135 degrees from both sides, I get that Z is equal to 45 degrees. So knowing that Z is equal to 45 degrees, this 45 degrees forms a linear pair with Y and is therefore supplementary. So 45 degrees plus the measure of angle Y is equal to 180 degrees, since the straight line is 180 degrees. When I subtract 45 degrees from both sides, I get that Y, our indicated angle in number 6, is equal to 135 degrees. On number 7, here is our indicated angle. Let's call this angle X. If you notice, X forms a vertical angle with this angle here. Let's call this angle A. And if we use the triangle sum theorem, adding 30 degrees to 20 degrees to A will give us 180 degrees. So now we can solve for A. 30 degrees plus 20 degrees plus A equals 180 degrees. Adding 30 degrees and 20 degrees together, we'll get that 50 degrees plus A equals 180 degrees. So when I subtract 50 degrees from both sides, I get that A is equal 180 degrees minus 50 degrees is 130 degrees. And since angle A and angle X are vertical angles, angle A, we know, is congruent to angle X. So if angle A equals 130 degrees, then by the vertical angle theorem, X is also equal to 130 degrees. And that's my solution in number 7. And lastly, let's go over the answer to number 8. In number 8, we're solving for this indicated angle here. Let's call this angle R. Angle R forms a linear pair with this angle. Let's call this angle S. And in order to solve for angle S, we're going to need to also solve for this angle, angle P, since P, S, and 60 degrees equal 180 degrees. And we can solve for P because P forms a linear pair with 155 degrees. So we know that 155 degrees plus P equals 180 degrees. When I subtract 155 degrees from both sides, we get that P is equal to 25 degrees. So knowing that P is 25 degrees, we can use the triangle sum theorem to solve for S. So we have 25 degrees plus 60 degrees plus S equals 180 degrees. 25 degrees plus 60 degrees equals 85 degrees. We're adding that to S, and that's equal to 180 degrees. Subtracting 85 degrees from both sides, we'll get that S is equal to 95 degrees. So knowing that S equals 95 degrees, and S is a linear pair with R, we can say that R plus 95 degrees equals 180 degrees. So subtracting 95 degrees from both sides, I'll get that R is equal to 85 degrees. So 85 degrees is my final solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll continue on with this worksheet, completing numbers 9 through 16. However, before you do that, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments below.